Wendy Griffith. President Obama addresses the United Nations General Assembly today.
He said the UN must enforce a ban on Syrian chemical weapons and that the U.S. will fight against nuclear weapons in Iran. Dale Hurd has more in tonight's top story.
After some missteps on Middle East policy in Syria and Egypt, President Obama told the United Nations today that the U.S. is not backing down from its opposition to Iran's nuclear program.
The United States of America is prepared to use all elements of our power, including military force, to secure our core interests in the region.
It was rumored that Obama might meet today with Iran's newly elected president, Hassan Rouhani.
I do believe that if we can resolve the issue of Iran's nuclear program, that can serve as a major step down a long road towards a different relationship.
It would be the first meeting of the nation's leaders since the Iran hostage crisis in 1979.
Diplomacy is good, but only if it brings about results.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu will also address the UN, and he's warning the world of an Iranian honey trap. A conciliatory-sounding approach from Iran's new leader that disguises the Islamic Republic's real intent to keep building a nuclear weapons program. The president today also addressed Syria, urging the UN Security Council to mandate consequences if Syria doesn't cooperate with a plan to hand over its chemical weapons.
If we cannot agree even on this, then it will show that the United Nations is incapable of enforcing the most basic of international laws.
Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Thanks, Dale. And our senior international correspondent, George Thomas, has spent time in Iran and joins us now for more. Thank you for being here, George.
Welcome.
Now, Iran's president seems to be mounting a charm offensive at the UN. Is this going to work?
Yeah, big question, you know, because for years, Iran has been the international bad boy on the scene. Mm-hmm. And suddenly it's become the diplomatic darling at the United Nations this week because Rouhani, Hassan Rouhani, the new president of Iran, days before coming to New York, he's in the country right now. He says, look, my goal is to put a new face to Iran in the eyes of the world, because for so many years, Iran has had bad press. And so he's coming to the United Nations, coming to New York, in essence, on a charm offensive to show the world that there is a new face to Iran. But listen, everybody needs to realize the former president of Iran, Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, he was unpolished. He said some crazy stuff at the United Nations, denying the Holocaust. Hassan Rouhani is going to come. He's going to come with eloquent, polished words. But we have to realize these guys are not in control. Khamenei, the spiritual leader of Iran, is the man in control. And Rouhani is an insider.
Do you think he's a wolf in sheep's clothing?
You know, and that's what the skeptics of this regime are saying. That's what Bibi Netanyahu is saying. But clearly, this is an insider. This is a man who was handpicked by the regime. He was allowed to run. So to anybody who thinks that just because he's going to speak differently than Mahmoud Ahmadinejad and will somehow, you know, bring a different view to the whole system is totally out of their mind.
Well, I understood that the president, Obama and Rouhani were supposed to have lunch today, but Rouhani was a no-show. That's not very charming.
No, but you know, that was the buzz. You know, the media and the White House was talking about a potential handshake. Look, if he had walked into the room during this luncheon and Obama moved over and held, you know, reached out his hand, obviously would have been huge, because not since 1979 has the United States had diplomatic relations with Iran. So for Rouhani and the president of the United States to have this, engage in this handshake would have been critical. But look, handshake or no handshake, Iran has to show that it is willing to stop, to curtail or to roll back its growing ambitions for a nuclear weapon. Until that happens, all this theatrics, look, the United Nations this week, all this is just theatrics. It's about speeches. Nobody cares about the speeches. And it's all about, you know, a pony show, in essence, you know. But what happens behind the scenes is obviously critical.
Okay, and real quick, Bibi Netanyahu is supposed to be there next week.
He is.
How do you think he's reacting to... I mean, he's the guy who's got to really deal with Iran, and he's got the world's now embracing this new guy.
Yeah, and he is set to talk, as you mentioned, next week. This is what he said. He said, Iran thinks soothing words and token actions will enable it to continue on its path to the bomb like North Korea before it. Iran will continue to work to have sanctions removed in return for cosmetic concessions while it continues to preserve its ability to quickly build a nuclear bomb. Israel is saying, listen, don't get bought into all of these theatrics. Yeah. This is not going to happen.
George, fascinating stuff. Thanks so much for being with us.
You're welcome.